What's going on, everybody? It's Stas here. So the markets weren't that great today. We had the S&P go down 0.7%. The Dow did break even, but the tech stocks, the NASDAQ 100 went down almost 2%, and the Russell went down 1.3%. So in this video, we're going to break down some technicals, go over some stocks that I'm looking at, and I want to break down some bad news that we got today from Janet Yellen, and you guys could probably guess what this is because it's a pretty big story breaking out, and I want to go over what I think could happen to the markets because of this. So without further ado, if you guys find value, hit the like button, subscribe, check out all the free links down below, and let's get right into the video. So you guys can see here on SPY, which is an S&P 500 ETF that we track every single day here on the channel, you can see SPY had a massive drop this morning, and I mean massive, right? It went from 416 to 411, and even bigger of a drop if you look at what happened pre-market. Pre-market, we were sitting at 417.50, so about a 1.5% drop here on SPY from pre-market to the lowest point of the day during the trading day. And we covered this morning on Patreon, and I mentioned to you all how I was seeing some bearish signs, right? If I pull up this 10-day chart, you guys can see there's two big levels. One of them's at 418 and the other one's 416.50. Now pay attention to what happened here pre-market, and we talked about this, like I said, this morning. Look at this. We failed at 418 pre-market. We tried breaking out of it. I mean, look, 4 a.m. on the East Coast, 5 a.m., 6 a.m., 7 a.m. We tried breaking out of 418, but we ultimately failed at 7:30 a.m. on the East Coast. We dropped all the way down to 416.50, which again, remember, that's another big level of support. We tried holding 416.50. We failed doing so as the market opened. Look, we tried breaking out of it again. We dumped aggressively under 416.50, and that is when we got to that low point of 411, which I've been talking about on this channel like no other, right? I've been talking about this spot over and over again because 411, that was support back in the end of April. So we hit 411 and we saw a recovery rally. And I mentioned this in the midday update on Patreon as well. Not trying to pitch the Patreon to you guys, but we literally talked about all of this stuff. And I mentioned in that video, we were slowly peeking out here on the intraday chart, and then we ended up rallying and recovering for the rest of the day, and we closed right under 416.50 again. So the way I'm looking at this now on SPY, before we get into what happened with Yellen and why the market sold off today, I'm thinking, okay, we got oversold on the 5-day, 5-minute. You can see it. We got oversold. This is simply a relief rally. The downtrend is not done yet, in my opinion. The volatility is not done yet either. And I wouldn't be surprised if we failed here at a lower high tomorrow at 416-ish, 416.50. Then we ended up dumping back off to test the lows from today at about 411. That would not surprise me whatsoever. And pulling up the 4-hour chart, maybe we end up breaking 411 and going to 408, 409. That's my next target here on SPY. So overall, why the heck did the market sell off today? Well, Janet Yellen, that is, she said that interest rates may have to rise. You heard that right. Interest rates may have to rise to keep the economy from overheating. And this is coming out of Janet Yellen's mouth and Jerome Powell. I'm assuming he's thinking the same thing, right? And both of these people, they've been saying, oh, no, there's no inflation. There's a little inflation. It's transitory. It's nothing to worry about. We're not going to raise interest rates. In fact, Jerome Powell, you've heard him say it. We're not even thinking about raising interest rates. And this is kind of a curveball. I mean, this is coming out of left field here. And a lot of people, the markets, investors, traders, they're like, holy crap, maybe they're going to raise interest rates very soon. And it's kind of obvious that Powell, Janet Yellen, they're just trying to calm and ease the nerves of investors, right? By saying, oh, there's not much inflation. It's transitory. We're not going to raise the rates. Because if they came out and said, yup, inflation's here, we're screwed, And we're going to raise rates to infinity. You know what that would do, guys? That would tank the stock market. So Jerome Powell, he's got to go by the script and be very, very careful with what he says, which is why when you watch these interviews, you can tell he's very careful with what he is saying. So, yeah, I mean, this is interesting stuff, guys. Now, interest rates, they might be coming back up sooner than expected. And she said the economy may be overheating because the Biden administration plans on spending a lot more money. President Biden has proposed roughly $4 trillion of new spending on infrastructure, social programs, and that's over the next decade, including funding for roads, bridges, research and development, affordable child care, paid family leave. So pretty much under this administration, we're going to see a lot more money printing. So they want to push up these rates, right? Because inflation is inevitably coming. It's here and there's no denying it anymore, which is why it's like, okay, come on, Janet Yellen, Jerome Powell, you know inflation's here. It's more than what you're portraying. I mean, come on. And now they're coming out and they're saying, yeah, it's we might have to raise those interest rates. And she said this at the summit, right? Pre-recorded interview, Future Economic Summit Holy crap, that's a tongue twister. Economy Summit. She said it may be that interest rates will have to rise somewhat to make sure that our economy doesn't overheat. So pretty much what I just said. And guys, again, this is after everything that these people have been saying, that inflation isn't here, the central bank isn't worried. And if you guys haven't checked out my inflation video, how to hedge against inflation, I go over what I'm doing. In fact, I show you all my gold collection. I'll link that video down below. Make sure to watch that. I made it about a week ago. Must watch video there. And as always, I'd love to know your thoughts on what's going on right now in the markets, Jerome Powell, Janet Yellen, inflation. And I feel like at this point in time, a lot of the high growth, the speculative stocks that do rely on this cheap money, hence why the NASDAQ went down a bunch. Let's take a look at QQQ while we're at it. I think a lot of these companies, guys, they're going to continue to sell off, and maybe they do see a spike back in the short term. That's very possible as well. But needless to say, there's going to be volatility. That's one thing I'm sure of. And yeah, these higher growth, a higher multiple, the companies that rely on this cheap money, they're going to be moving like crazy. Let's put it that way. And we saw a lot of that today, as we saw the growth stocks, they got hammered. The QQQ stocks got hammered. NASDAQ, you know, all that stuff. And you can see here, QQQ went down 1.8%. And this also pretty much hit one of our key levels that we were talking about, right? We failed at 335 this morning. This was very, very bad. When the markets opened, guys, the fact that we tanked under 335, in fact, we were under 335 before the markets even opened. Then the markets opened at 333, and then we saw a push all the way down to 326, which was that resistance point for a lot of February, well, mostly the end of February, and a lot of March, right? So the fact that we held 326, we saw a bit of a recovery off of that low today, that makes sense. And I feel like maybe we could see a bit more of a relief rally on the QQQ ETF here, maybe up to 332, 333 even. But as we do see, if we see another pump, I'd expect there to be some selling coming in at about 333, 334 to push this thing back down, maybe even to take the lows out from today. And you guys remember, last little side note on this inflation, rising rates and so forth, raising rates, however you want to say it. Do you all remember what happened in 2018? Little history lesson here, although it's only 3 years ago, but still, some of you guys were not in the markets, right? So 3 years ago, they tried increasing interest rates, and look what happened to the markets. Do you remember it was in, December? You guys can see here, it was about May, June, July, August, September of 2018. That's when they started to try to raise those interest rates. And look at what happened to the markets. SPY, if I zoom in a bit here, this sell-off period, you guys can see it went from 292 and it sold off. I think the bottom, no joke, was Christmas Eve, right? The day before Christmas, we bottomed out. Yeah, literally. Look at that, guys. I literally remember this like it was yesterday, right? So we went from 292 down to 230 because they were trying to increase the interest rates, and that was a 20% drop. It dropped to a bear market like this, guys. I mean, it wasn't as fast as we saw some other sell-offs, but it went down pretty quickly in the span of about 60, 70, 80 days. So in 2 months, the market was in a bear market, and then they were like, no, 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 we can't increase these rates. They dropped them back down, right? And yeah, the market took off from there, and that proved to be a pretty nice dip buy, and I was actually buying stocks back then, and again, the market recovered from there. So what do you think? Drop a comment down below. I'd love to know your thoughts, and if you all are enjoying the video so far, make sure to hit the like button, and let's get into some stocks now. Number one is Activision Blizzard, ATVI. This one, they just reported earnings today. They did EPS of 98 cents versus 70 cents, so a pretty nice beat there, and revenue came in at $2.07 billion versus $1.78 billion estimated, and they also raised the guidance from what I was reading. You guys can see that here, Q2 guidance tops estimates, and the stock is up about $6, a little bit under $6 after hours. So finally some green I'm seeing today. You know, this is, you know, one of the only stocks that's green after hours at this point. It's up over 5-6%. So kudos to anybody that owns Activision. Now with this good earnings report, we can see we've squeezed ourselves back into deeper into this wedge. You guys can see clearly we ended up holding 88 at a higher low. Now we recovered above 90, which was support pretty much all of March, right? So that's a good sign as well. And now we're pushing up towards this resistance, the resistance of the wedge at about $95. And we've already broken above, as of now, both moving averages here. So I need to see 95 break. In fact, let me just make a new alert and change it from 95.60 to about $95 flat. So if we break 95, this could end up being a breakout play overall. And mind you, Activision Blizzard is a company that, yeah, could be affected a little bit because of these interest rates coming up, but they're still a profitable company, so they're not relying as much on this cheap money as, let's say, I don't want to single out a different stock, but as, let's just say, a more speculative, higher growth stock, right? So Activision's looking pretty good. I think this could be a nice play above $95. Shopify's also doing pretty well. Shopify went up 2%. Today, and I think this close was pretty bullish, especially since we closed above 1140. 1140 was resistance back in September, back in October, also back in March a little bit. So the fact that we closed above that, that is good. Now I'd love to see a break above both moving averages here on the 4 hour, probably above 1160. So I'm going to put an alert at 1160 on Shopify. If 1160 breaks, listen to this, guys. I think we're going to be going up 1260, right? 1250 at least. That could be a move of about 7-8% from where we are right now. And look, that's the next big gap to fill. And for all we know, we might not get up there because, again, we're still trading under the moving averages. So there's always a chance we dump off from here. But that's why I put my alert at 1160, because I want to see if it breaks the moving averages, then we're going to see momentum. And we had Skills report today as well. Pretty solid report from Skills. The stock isn't doing much after hours. Revenue came in at $83.7 million. That's up 92% year over year. EPS came in at negative 15 cents, and their Q1 paying monthly active users were up 81% year over year. So that's pretty good. That along with the revenue growth, and they raised guidance, full year 21 guidance, sales guidance from $336 million to $375 million versus the $369 million estimated. So I'm pretty shocked, to be honest. Well, then again, not not really, because there is some selling pressure on the markets, but I would think that skill should be up on this report, you know, after reporting this. And we'll see, you know, the next couple of days, we might get that upswing back over 17-18. So we'll see. And overall, again, solid report there for skills. I'm happy with that, as I do own a swing position in them right now. And we also saw Pfizer report. They did EPS of 98 cents or 93 cents rather versus the 78 cents estimated, and revenue came in at 14.6 billion versus 13.6 billion estimated. So they beat EPS, beat revenue. They raised their guidance full year 2021 EPS to 355 to 365 from 310 to 320. So that's a big increase in their EPS guidance. And they raised their revenue guidance pretty drastically from 59.4 to 61.4 billion. That's the range before. Now they're looking at 70 to 72.5 billion. So that is an insane increase in guidance. And that's versus the about 63 billion estimated from analysts. So I really like this. I really like this from Pfizer. And we also broke out of 39 bucks, holding that as support right now. In fact, earlier we were above $40. So I think Pfizer will ultimately consolidate a bit, maybe at 39, 40 bucks. But I think it's going to see a leg up above 41. 42, maybe even back to 43 in due time, as we're seeing, obviously, the V-shot roll around the world, India now. So I think Pfizer has potential. Coinbase is another one, which I also own along with Skills. And I actually bought more Coinbase today. And everybody on Patreon, you know that. You get my buy and sell alerts, morning update videos, call outs. All of that's on Patreon at patreon.com/DossSurfest. And this is one that the closer and closer it gets to 250, which is the price that it was originally listed at for its direct listing, the closer it gets to that, the better. I'm going to be buying it, right? And today I bought at 280. I bought a couple weeks ago, pretty much like 10 days ago about. I bought at 330 roughly. So I'm going to be averaging down. And please give me 250. Please give me under 250. I'm going to be buying this because I'm pretty bullish on Coinbase. I think crypto is here to stay. And you buying Coinbase is a bet that you believe cryptocurrency, Bitcoin, Ethereum, all of those on that exchange, you believe those are going to be bigger and more widely bought and sold in the next 5-10 years, right? And I'm actually buying this as a medium to long-term swing. And who knows, I might start buying shares for the long term now as well. I probably will the closer we get to 250. And the last stock for today, guys, before we wrap things up, because we talked about a lot of heavy stuff in today's video. And again, let me know your thoughts down below. The last one today is Snapchat, which is one of those companies that could be hurt from these interest rates going up. You know, this went down 6% today. And you guys can see as of now, it is holding the uptrend. Believe it or not, it is holding the uptrend at a higher low at about $53. It recovered over $55. So earlier in the day, it was down a lot more than what it was at the close of the market. In fact, it had a nice close. In the last 2 hours, it ran about 4 or 5%. So it was down 10% at one point. And I think overall, guys, Snapchat could see maybe a relief rally to about 60 bucks. Maybe 61, 62 would be pushing it. But I would say 58, 60 at least, as we are oversold here. We saw QQQ's oversold, so maybe we get a snapback day tomorrow, followed by more selling. And for that reason, I'd be looking at this more as a day trade, maybe a 1-2 day swing trade. So watch out for this, maybe $56 to about $59. That could be the range. So I'm going to put an alert is at or above $56. So that's it. I hope you all enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button. Feel free to subscribe and feel free to check out my video from earlier. I break down my highest conviction stock. I show you all my YouTube analytics for one video, which I haven't done. So if you're interested in seeing how much money I've made from one video, one of my biggest videos, check out that video from earlier. And we also go over my M1 portfolio in that video. So I'll link that down below. You could also join the free Discord chat, free Facebook group. You can get $30 from M1 Finance, 2 stocks from WeBull as well. Those are valued up to $1,600. All you have to do is deposit $100 into WeBull, $100 into M1, and you get those free perks, the free money. All of those are linked down below. Same with my Patreon at patreon.com/DotSurfFest. That's linked down below for buy and sell alerts, call outs, morning update videos, more one-on-one access with me. That is on Patreon. Again, that's at patreon.com/DotSurfFest. So I'll see you all in the next video, which is that video from earlier. I'll pop it up here. See you guys there. Stay safe out there. As always, keep crushing the markets. Peace out.